Todo mundo quiero viva su historia. Yo quiero eso más que tú. Soy Ian el Huracán Heinisch. Y eso es mi camino para UFC 241.
Muay Thai, training with my boy Austin Jones. This is my Derek Brunson for this camp. You know, we're getting ready. We're just watching the Contender Series. The guy missed weight by 7 pounds. This guy's on a five-fight win streak. Five fights. Get him on. He earned his opportunity. Let this man get in there. Weight. He'll put a show on in front of Dana White, Sean Shelby, Mick Maynard. Hit him up. Austin Jones. This is my man.
Let's go.
X on the chest.
August 17th.
Winning tournaments, so that was the problem because it enabled me to continue to do what I was doing. And I woke up and the wheels were spinning. It was snow outside and I drove a Mustang and I woke up and my foot was still on the gas and I got out and I just ran home and I got expelled and they were like, yeah, no way. So another great opportunity I missed because of my addiction problems. I was missing something in relationship with God. I mean, I partied, I rested. So I started selling ecstasy pills and about 6 to 8 months of that, I got caught, set up in a Walmart parking lot, a pistol to my head, and I got busted. And I hopped on a Greyhound to Indiana, say goodbye to my family. Then I hopped on a train to New York, and I hopped on a plane from JFK to Amsterdam with about $2,000 in my pocket. I made my way to Belgium, and then eventually to England. And eventually I landed in a place called Tenerife, the Canary Islands, Spain. It was a paradise to me, but my job was working at a club. And I was getting 8 drinks when I worked, 4 drinks when I got off. So I was a full-blown alcoholic within 3 months, even worse than ever. I was homeless. Some nights I would have to sleep on the beach and it would be windy, so I would dig a hole. I met a Colombian family that said, hey, gringo, we don't want to see you living like this. His son grew up in Miami, so it was the only other American on the island. And they took me in like family, they still are. But eventually when I sobered up, they said, hey, gringo, let's go make some real money. We started trafficking cocaine. We started flying down to Colombia, Mexico, Aruba, packaging cocaine from Rikers Island, which was the worst experience that you could imagine. I was one of the only white boys to ever be in maximum security. Yes, because I was a fugitive. Put a SOS on me, which meant stab on sight. And so the next morning, I was basically going to be stabbed by all these guys. I stayed up all night praying and just making weapons and armor and just waiting for these guys to come in the morning. About an hour before the doors opened, came the U.S. Marshal, and they pulled me out of this prison cell. Who are you guys? They said, U.S. Marshal. So we hopped on a van, shackled head to toe, and they drove us to Jefferson County, eventually after 11 days of just circling the country like this, being treated like an animal. Like, so if you guys think, you know, your life's hard right now, like, don't even try the prison system in America. There's no reform in our prison system, so do whatever you can to stay out of the system. and just focus on your dreams. I got bailed out 2014 Valentine's Day, and now I'm 16-1, 13-1 as a professional, and now I'm ranked number 11 in the world in the UFC. And it was because I found my purpose. I found a relationship with Jesus. And now I can use my story and my troubles as a testimony to share to you guys. So I hope you guys can get something from this. I went from rock bottom in a prison cell in a foreign country to be fighting the number 8 guy on pay-per-view in UFC 241 in Anaheim, California, August 17th. Constantly on a daily basis, do the right things, the little things, and work towards your goals and find your purpose and your why. You guys can really accomplish anything, especially at your guys' age, man. And just remember, what is your purpose and what's your why? Who are you doing this for? Not just yourself, because if it's selfish, you guys will fold in opposition. But if you're doing it for something greater, your parents, you know, your legacy, your family, to have the strength to go through any obstacle. And I truly believe that. So that's my story, and that's my time for you guys.